Those who know me know I am from the old school. And in the old school, you did everything father or sister told you to do. Isn't that right? Say yes, Bishop. Well, we're going to do an old school thing. We're going to all sing. And if you have a bad voice, God deserves to hear it, so he won't make that mistake again. Amen? Now, let me sing it through first, and then y'all could join in, okay? If anybody asks you who I am, who I am, who I am, if anybody asks you who I am, tell them I'm a child of God. If anybody asks you who I am, who I am, who I am, if anybody asks you who I am, tell them I'm a child of God. Now, some of y'all looking at me like y'all crazy, but I want everybody to sing. Amen? Stand up. Okay, let's go. If anybody asks you who I am, who I am, who I am, if anybody asks you who I am, tell them I'm a child. My father is rich in houses and land. He holds the world in the palm of his hand. Rubies and diamonds, silver and gold, just tell them I'm a child of God. Yes, if anybody asks you who child of God. If you don't believe I've been redeemed, just follow me down to that old Jordan stream. I stepped in the water was cold, chilled my body, but not my soul. Yeah. If anybody asks you who I am, who I am, who I am, if anybody asks you who I am, tell them I'm a child of God. If anybody asks you who Actor Samuel L. Jackson, Doyle Gibbons, and Ben Affleck, Gavin Bennett starred in a 2002 box office hit, Changing Lanes. This fast-paced, action-packed movie was about two strangers in New York City dealing with the erosion and corrosion of life that plagued and ate away at the moral fabric of each of their lives. These two men were both addicted to chaos and turmoil found in their sphere of existence and life. And as life would have it, Doyle and Gavin's path crossed due to a fender bender. The encounter of these two men only exacerbated the disorder and confusion in their worlds, caught up in their complicated environment and chaotic circumstances. Both Doyle and Gavin made conscious and critical decisions at the crossroads of their lives to slow their paces and alter their courses. Living on the edge, Doyle and Gavin proposed in their hearts to change lanes. And changing lanes would bring some order, maturation, and sanctity to each of their lives. Rather than being consumed by the anarchy and the insanity that life sometimes brings, Doyle and Gavin decided to wear life as a loose garment and never forfeit the privilege to adapt and adopt to life's ever-changing conditions. God in Christ gives to each of us, as we observe another Martin Luther King Jr. birthday celebration, this ability and privilege of changing lanes. And Dr. King himself said, "The time is always right to do what is right. Intelligence plus character, that is the goal of true education. Always be sure that you struggle with Christian methods and Christian weapons that make you better. Never succumb to the temptation of becoming bitter." In other words, each person needs to discover and or rediscover what it means to be created in the image of God and to be named a child of God, so that they could tell everybody, "I am a child of God." Each person needs to develop relationships of love that are mutually fulfilling. Each person needs to know who God is and what God intends for one's life and one's future, and to work for love, true agape,
and equality, peace, and justice in the world. Isn't that a good plan? Say yes, Bishop. Don't y'all fall asleep on me. Most of the time, we are unaware of it, but changing lanes is an inescapable, unavoidable, and inevitable part of life and living. Birth, life's maturation, education, formal and informal, marriage, family, vocation, occupation, experience, exposure, trial and discipline, hurt and disappointment, and even death. In the midst of all of these, we are always changing lanes. Over one Christmas holiday, I had the privilege of driving home to New Orleans, and I was driving from Atlanta, Georgia. What I observed in driving round trip, that when the lanes shifted, if you were the driver, you shifted too. If you refused to shift, accidents occurred, people were hurt or injured, death was ensuing, cars were left alone on the median and out of the flow of traffic. Delays and jams were certain. Traffic would slow down and just simply pass you by. Given ample warnings and the ominous signs along the way, if one refused to heed, the inevitable would happen. No one could be blamed but the driver. Remember, only you can signal that you are changing lanes. In other words, Dr. King would simply say, returning violence for violence multiplies violence, adding deeper darkness to a night already devoid of stars. Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. And according to Henry David Thoreau, things do not change. People change. Changing lanes, as I view it, is the option and our alternative at each of our disposals. The hope of a secure and livable world lies with disciplined unconformists who are dedicated to justice, peace, and brotherhood. So for our time that we have to share this afternoon, as we commemorate the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., our text today calls us to deal with humanity facing the harsh realities of life and the graces of God afforded humanity for changing lanes. Jesus is being overwhelmed by the multitude pressing against him and around him for one purpose, to listen to the word of God. And all of this was down by the lake of Gennesaret, the Sea of Galilee. Two boats were lying at the edge of the lake, but the fishermen had gotten out of their boats and they were washing their nets. Sounds like they were done fishing. Jesus used Simon's boat as the platform to teach to the multitudes of people that thronged him. Upon Jesus' conclusion of his didactic truths to the multitude, he had a word of knowledge for Simon Peter. Launch out into the deep and let your nets down for a catch. In other words, Christ told Peter to change lanes. And could it be Christ is telling you and me, it is past time. We need to change lanes. Simon responded, "Master, we worked hard all night and caught nothing." Let's investigate this a little bit. In changing lanes, be sure that you do not give up prematurely. Often in life, we give up prematurely because things don't go our way. Things don't work out the way we planned. Life doesn't treat us fair or fine. We get so engrossed in someone else's life, we forget about our own life. Do you know people like that? I do. Maybe not here in Carolina, but there are people like that in other places. Sometimes we choose to do things on our own without divine consultation, assistance, direction, and our intervention. This day and our generation is filled with a lack of commitment, a lack of appreciation, a lack of stick-to-itness, a lack of hard work, and a lack of ingenuity. We just don't want to change lanes. Thus, as soon as life throws us a curveball, we cringe, cave in, and are ready to throw in the towel. Remember, Dr. King espoused, "Let no man pull you low enough to hate them." Don't place limitations on yourself, and don't allow others to place limitations on you. Whatever happened to that old saying, "If at first you don't succeed, try again"? That sounds like changing lanes, doesn't it? Don't give up prematurely. I remember going back in time when Bush, Cheney, and the Congress appropriated $300 billion for investing in our military prowess. And our children and the public school systems across the country were left to fail. And in majority proportions, and the results are simple. Ill-prepared generations to come to compete in the real world. And they are forced to embrace their own demons, vices, and demises. I remember there was a thrust by the conservatives to blame the most disrespected two-term African-American president of this country for the very problems they and their own created. I remember about the systemic evil, brutal shootings that continue to take place at the hands of law enforcement across this country. And the legal system protects and acquits them in record numbers. I remember the FBI and CIA can catch Michael Jackson and Kobe Bryant and R. Kelly for wrongful actions, yet we can't catch gun suppliers and distributors, the real culprits of drug trafficking, and the sure enough pimps who exploit our young people for profit. When war and bloodshed are more lucrative over the control of petroleum and oil than peace that passes all understanding and love that looks beyond human frailty. When people will frequent the church for social status, go and take photo ops with Bibles in their hands, but will not attend to the spiritual infrastructures of the church for growth and maturity in their own lives. Attending Mass and Bible studies, prayer meetings, and Sunday school, and those things that make us better people. When what you have is more important than what has you. When the family unit, father, mother, and child or children, is a thing of the past and being replaced by dysfunctional paradigms and radical shifts, and the people of God remain silent. Do you remember that time when Capitol Hill and state officials and supreme legislators stopped the nation for the life of Terry Schiavo, but ignored Terry Negro? The countless blacks and others who die every day because they have no health care, no advocates, no appeals. And Lord, don't get me started on the border control and detention centers in this country. So when we come up short, empty, and without, barren sometimes, staying right there and keep plugging away, a lack of productivity doesn't always warrant giving up, but rather a continued commitment to invest in spite of what life sometimes shows us. That is why Jesus said to us, let the wheat and the weed grow together, and at harvest time, I'll do the separating. We give in, we give up too soon because we have been seduced by the supersonic and instantaneous paradigms of our times. We are not called to be successful, but faithful. That's what Samuel said to Saul in that first reading. Not quantity, but quality. What did you do with my son, Jesus the Christ? And Dr. King would raise this inquiry. Life's most persistent question is, what are you doing for others? That's changing lanes. Don't give up prematurely. Hang on in there. Peter responded by saying to his own excuse, but nonetheless, at your word, I will let down the nets. Which brings me to the second big point I want to make. In changing lanes, don't let your past paralyze you in the present. Based on these fishermen's toil all night and coming up short with nothing, daytime fishing was not even a remote possibility and or option for them. If we allow the shortcomings of yesterday to paralyze us today, then tomorrow will never be seized and or appreciated. As Peter had that nonetheless moment, all of us, as we change lanes, must employ a nonetheless moment, or the nonetheless moments, realizing that if God said it, that settles it, whether you believe it or not. Jesus said, launch out into the deep. The implication of such a divine imperative, launch out, are these. You are too shallow. You got what it takes, all the necessary tools to get the task done. You haven't begun to tap into your God-given potential. God will help us to see through the lenses of faith our divine perspective. The best is yet to be discovered. Going through the motions and even emotions does not mean obedience. Discouragement does not defeat nor deflate determination. Every failure is a proof that with faith, destiny shall be accomplished. You see, my brothers and sisters, what had happened to Peter could have affected what was going to happen to Peter. The night yesterday brought nothing but emptiness, weariness, and discouragement. The day today brought with it infinite possibilities, hope beyond imagining, strength despite human weakness, and faith that saw and reached what Christ had already seen and knew to be. Dr. King admonished, if a man is called to be a street sweeper, he should sweep streets even as Michelangelo painted or Beethoven composed music, or Shakespeare wrote poetry. He should sweep streets so well that all the host of heaven and earth would pause to say, here lived a great street sweeper who did his job well. Launch out into the deep. Don't become paralyzed. You must keep plugging away. Thirdly, in changing lanes, you can always expect when the dust clears that you will be blessed abundantly. Hard work, intentionality, commitment pays off, even if it's in the end. Do you think that the school of fish just miraculously appeared in the lake of Gennesaret? Once Jesus said, launch out into the deep? No, I submit to you that the fish were already there all the time. But the schools of mature fish travel in deeper waters. If you are looking for minnows, they are found in shallow waters, but they are really good for nothing but to be bait for bigger fish. If we are going to do great things for God, for others, and for ourselves, we must not be afraid to launch out into the deep, the unknown, the incognito, and the uncharted and unidentified. Dr. King encouraged, faith is taking the first step, even when you don't see the whole stairway. You see, birds of a feather do flock together. You must surround yourself with people who know the last value of changing, the lasting value of changing lanes and launching out into the deep. The text says that Peter stepped out on what the Lord said, and the other fishermen followed his lead. Verse 6 says, and when they had done this, they were all blessed beyond measure, to the point that they had to call in their partners to carry the load of fish caught because somebody had the good sense of changing lanes. Note, the mark of leadership is influencing others to the point that they benefit from your blessings. All of us are blessed today because of someone else. a mother or father who cared, a single parent who hung in there, grandparents who assisted and shared, extended family who instilled values, churches and communities of faith who invested in us, teachers who imparted lessons to us, good people who gave of their time and resources for us, neighbors who extended themselves. We are all blessed here today. We followed somebody's godly example. Changing lane confronts all of us. So some helpful tidbits that you need to hold on to are these. Allow the Lord and His word to lead you. Choose wisely the company you keep. Remember those who invest in your life. Give back to the community that gave to you. And be blessed. And be a blessing to somebody else. I'd like to close sharing with you my story. Really, this is my song. 2 weeks before ordination to the diaconate, I was refused ordination. I remember that day, because I had to go tutor a young man at a high school in New Orleans. As I worked with him, he could see that I was totally distracted, and he asked me, "What's wrong with you?" And I began to share with him, I was just told that I would not be ordained. Out of the mouth of a child, he said to me, "I know you are a good minister, and God knows you are a good minister, and it is God who ordains anyway." I had to change lanes. When told twice by the personnel board of the Archdiocese of New Orleans that they had no place to send me in the 156 parishes in the Archdiocese, God placed me in a parish that went through tremendous struggle, where three black youth were pistol beat in church for going to communion before white folk. Journeying with that community, sharing in their struggles, it made my struggle look like nothing and taught me about what it means to be, to overcome struggle and still be resolved to serve the Lord in your life. There was a time I had a real knockout drag out with my archbishop. And the leadership of the Knights and Ladies of Peter Claver and the Ladies Auxiliary took me by the hand and said, "Young priest, come here." And they sat me down and led me to go into the deep with the archbishop. And it saved my vocation as a priest of God. When confronted by naysayers who are against black Catholic worship in the Catholic Church, the Like Foundation team still produce conferences that reflect black Catholic liturgy. And we were encouraged and strengthened by those who were renewed by its power for our commitment and life. And when I thought I had done everything that I could do as a priest in the church, Pope Francis appointed me Auxiliary Bishop of New Orleans. Sometimes you just gotta change lanes. That's my story. That's my song. Anything that is not God-centered cannot come and take root in your lives. You gotta root it out. You have to change lanes. You have to make Christ the center of your being. Make that your goal in 2022. For when it is Christ-centered, you could change lanes easily, knowing that with God at your side, you have nothing at all to fear. We can move when the Spirit says move. We can sing when the Spirit says sing. We can do when the Spirit says do, because we are all children of God. Amen.